And Luminar has been viewed as a LiDAR darling, largely for being one of the first to go public. It's early to win high-profile production contracts. The company recently reported fourth quarter results and unveiled a new LiDAR sensor that's already begun to ship to its lead customer, along with its other initiatives. With other automakers adopting LiDAR to make vehicles safer, is Luminar shaping up to be the leader of the automotive revolution? Here to discuss is Luminar Technologies CEO, Austin Russell. Austin, good to talk to you. I guess like we'll know that we've gotten to a different point where we don't have to explain what LiDAR is, but I think a lot of people are still wrapping their heads around it.
There is never a dull moment in the tech world. It's constantly evolving and innovating industry, which has seen multi-billionaires such as Elon Musk become a household name.
He's one of the world's richest men and owns SpaceX, Tesla, and Twitter. So when Elon Musk speaks, his words, well chosen or not, have the ability to move the money markets. He bought Twitter for just over £35 billion last October, but said the company was losing money and he'd have to cut.
Musk's presence online is no longer just about his business practices. His views, ideologies, and character are also in the spotlight. In recent months, he's received huge amounts of backlash, but also plenty of support and praise for his turbulent acquisition of Twitter. As a result, he has a large and dedicated fan base, but he also has received heavy criticism. However, with constantly new innovations come new inventors and leaders. Austin Russell is the CEO of an automotive sensor firm, Luminar Technologies, which went public in 2020. Following Luminar's listing on NASDAQ, Russell gained the title of world's youngest self-made billionaire at just 25 years old. In doing so, he knocked the Kardashian clan's youngest sister, Kylie Jenner, off her podium since she had previously held the title.
When you have to build something truly from the ground up, everything is a challenge. You know, it's not a trivial one. I mean, you have to be able to ensure that you're successfully balancing all the different aspects of the business beyond the core technology development.
Austin was raised in the Sunshine State of California. His parents were incredibly well-to-do. His father, Michael Russell, worked in commercial real estate, but is now employed at Luminar. His mother, Shannon Cly, is a former model and actress known primarily for her role in The Young and the Restless. The new tech superstar was clearly not a stranger to money, but it's unlikely that he expected to have an estimated net worth of $1.7 billion by just 25 years old. There were signs from an early age that Russell was destined for success. An example of his early genius is that he is said to have memorized the periodic table of elements when he was at the tender age of 2. He filed his first patent at just 13. The patent was for a groundwater recycling system to reuse water from sprinklers. He was clearly a very bright and ambitious teenager. At 17 years old, he founded the business that has now bought him an $83 million mansion next door to Tom Hanks. The young CEO set up Luminar with the aim to develop automotive LiDAR, light detection and ranging technology.
Rather, how do we enable this kind of technology to really see the light of day in as many automakers as possible? Because, you know, it's not like you can just take a stack from an existing AV company and apply it to this. It's actually a totally different, you know, problem that everyone else has solved. It's not a one-to-one. So that's what's really special about this and kind of where we went all in. And that applies, you know, from both everything from the basics around, you know, the LiDAR and obviously algorithms and processing, and like we actually make our own chips that even go into the LiDAR itself.
In essence, the tech uses lasers to detect and measure distance. This information can be used to create a 3D map of the real-world surroundings that can be used in self-driving cars. It was an ambitious goal, particularly whilst judging his studies of applied physics at Stanford University. Austin was completely dedicated to his passion, and so he eventually made the decision to drop out of college. Russell told Forbes, "When you have this fundamental drive to be able to build, to be able to create, it's very challenging to do that in an academic environment." Despite the remarkable success and following that Russell has created, not everyone seems happy for him. In 2019, Tesla CEO and fellow tech mogul Elon Musk, who is around twice the age of Austin, said that LiDAR technology was freaking stupid, expensive, and unnecessary. That's according to CNBC. Russell was obviously of a very different opinion. He told the publication, "I think 50 commercial partners and a majority of the major car makers we are working with would disagree. Cameras and other systems are great for assisted driving, but with autonomy, that's where a really high-performance LiDAR is needed." This exchange between the two billionaires suggests that there is some tension between the two of them, which is entirely understandable. We can only imagine that this tension will increase as Russell's fame does. On January 1, 2022, the young CEO donated $4 million to the highly effective Team Seize campaign. Marketed as hashtag Team Seize, the fundraiser is an international effort that was started by famous YouTubers MrBeast and Mark Rober as a follow-up to Team Trees. Overall, the collaborative fundraiser succeeded in raising over $33 million, with the promise that donations would go towards the Ocean Conservancy and ocean cleanup. The aim of the project was to remove 30 million pounds, or 14 million kilograms of marine debris from the oceans by the end of 2021. That's 1 pound of trash for every dollar donated. This means that Russell's sole donation removed a mighty 4 million pounds of debris from the ocean. Austin's philanthropic donation garnered him a lot of praise, particularly from a younger audience who are generally very concerned about the climate crisis. Across all his YouTube channels, MrBeast has over 35 billion views and 222 million loyal subscribers. His reach and influence is pervasive and strong, so for many folks who are Gen Z or young millennials, the billionaire's donations have really put him in their good books. His other philanthropic efforts have continued the upward trajectory of his public image. After moving the headquarters of his business to Orlando, Florida, he gifted $70 million to the Central Florida Foundation. His financial gifts have helped fund community initiatives and hurricane relief. It's a positive thing that he's investing back into his local community. Of course, this doesn't discount Musk's charitable donations. In 2021, the Tesla CEO donated $5.74 billion to charity and is known to have a vested interest in renewable and clean energy. It is clear to anyone that in a lot of ways, Russell and Musk have a lot of similarities, from the industries they're leaders in to their donations towards climate-related causes. However, at the current pace, it seems as though Austin Russell's following, leadership, and innovations just keep growing. He's recently been featured on the coveted 40 Before 40 list and the Times 100 list. He's been receiving a lot of praise and accolades for his contribution to the tech and automobile industries, whereas Musk keeps falling into more and more online controversy, which could greatly harm his public reputation. If that does happen, will Austin Russell rise to fill Musk's shoes? Will he truly become the next Elon Musk? Only time will tell.